This is what the Lord, the God of your father David, says. I have heard your prayers and seen your tears. He said, I have heard your prayer and seen your tears. 2 Kings chapter 20 verse 5. Dear child of God, it is true that there are so many situations that have caused you to cry yourself out every day. You have cried, you have wept so much to the point that strength have left you. The Lord is telling you today that I have seen your tears. You have cried for a change in that situation. You have cried making demand on the Lord to bring you that testimony speedily. You have cried because you don't want to see the pains and all the things your family members are going through to continue. The Lord is saying to you today that He has seen your tears. The Lord is saying to you today that He has heard your prayers. You see, when times get bad, people cry out for help. And the Lord is telling you today that the help that you have cried out for, you are going to receive it. He's saying to you today that that relief you are crying out for, you are going to receive it. It's the Lord that is always concerned about every teardrop that comes from your eyes. It's the one that gathers every tear that comes from your eyes. So He's very concerned about all the things that you are going through. He doesn't like the fact that you are crying every day. He doesn't like the fact that you are in pains. He doesn't like the fact that the situations that you are going through have brought you down. But He's assuring you with this word today that He has seen your tears. This is what the Lord, the God of your father David, says. I have heard your prayer and seen your tears. Every of those petitions you have made to Him, every of those supplications you have brought before Him, every of those tears you have shared before His presence is telling you today that He has seen those tears and He will do something about that situation. He's telling you today that He has seen the things you are going through and He would make sure that you would have a testimony. He's telling you today that He would wipe the tears off your eyes and you would have a cause to rejoice again. He's reminding you today that He's concerned about you. The way He was concerned about David and did something for him that will cause him to rejoice. The same way He did it for Ruth is the same way He will do it for you. The same way He did it for Naomi, He will do it for you. He has seen your tears. He knows those things you are crying to Him for every day. He knows that reason why you have locked yourself up. But He's telling you, dear child of God, I've seen your tears and I will do something about it. In Psalms 28 verse 2, He says, hear the voice of my supplications when I cry unto thee. And the Lord is assuring you today that He will hear the voice of your supplications. Every of the supplications you have made before Him is assuring you today that He will do something about it. That thing that has caused you to spend a lot of money crying, when will it change? He's telling you today, like He heard the woman with the issue of blood, who has spent all of her resources, who had given all that she had to the physicians. The Lord heard her cry, and everything she did in faith received a testimony. I want you to know that the Lord has heard your cry, and everything you will do from this moment on in faith will be the result of your testimony. Don't be afraid to launch out and do the needful, because God has heard your cry. It's time that you ask the Lord to bring you that victory and be sure that you want it. It's time that you tell the Lord, I don't want to cry anymore. It's time that you tell the Lord, I don't want to wet my pillow anymore in tears. I'm tired of crying, and please change my situation. And the same way he did it for David, he would do it for you. The same way he did it for Naomi, he would do it for you. The same way he did it for that woman with the issue of blood, he would do it for you. The eyes of the Lord are upon the righteous, and his ears are open unto their cry. Psalms 34 verse 5. The Lord's ear had been open to your cry. And dear child of God, I want you to know that he has heard every of your petition. He said he's open unto your cry, which means everything that those tears has brought forth, he wants to change it. He wants to see that you have a turnaround testimony. He wants to see that you have a victory. He wants to see that that thing that you are crying about, the Lord had changed it. And I want to assure you today, he will do it in a way that you do not expect it. He will do it in a fashion and in a manner that will keep you surprised. He will do it in a way that will leave you astonished. He is God and is ever concerned about you. He will do something in your life that will change all of your mornings to dancing in the name of Jesus. He knows all those cries you have cried. He knows all those tears you have sown as a seed. And is telling you, you will reap in joy. You will reap when your morning comes. And your morning has come already. You will have a cause to rejoice in the mighty name of Jesus. You have a cause to testify. You would have a cause to lift up your hands and say, thank you, Lord, for you came through for me. Dear child of God, you would have a testimony. Hold on to God. Hold on to faith. And do not give up. The Lord will bring that testimony to you speedily. In the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. He said, this is what the Lord, the God of your father David, says. I have heard your prayer and seen your tears. The Lord has seen your tears, and he wants to assure you today that you will testify in the name of Jesus. So don't give up. Be ready to testify. Don't give up. Be ready to testify. Do not give up, dear child of God. Be ready to testify. It is well with you, beloved. God bless you. And Shalom.